Passionate, definitely. Determined, definitely. And stubborn. He just keeps going and going and going.
I'd heard of him, you know, at the start of my career, you know, legendary techno DJ from Belgium. So when I finally got to meet him, great honour.
It's always nice to meet him and to speak with him because he's such a honest and a nice person, a great DJ and a great producer.
But his enthusiasm for what he creates is unbelievable, and it's been unbelievable all the way up until nowadays. You know, the 21st century Marco Bailey is a strong, if not stronger now than ever.
What gives me the most good feeling inside is when I can see going people crazy on the dance floor, when I see smiles on the face with the music that I bring them. And to welcome the people in your world of music and then seeing smiles on the face, this is the most fantastic moment for me of being a DJ. I first realized that I wanted to be a DJ only on my age of 18. I was only interested in sports, you know. It was my complete dream, you know, being a sportman. And I did motocross. This was my life, 24 hours a day. I was so possessed about it. This was everything for me. Until I broke, you know, arm and here some ribs and stuff. And I lost a lot of blood also. Thanks God to my beautiful father, to my great father who helped me. Until I had this bad fall, this sad accident, actually, and then I stopped, and then I start going out. But after 3-4 times going out, you know, and dating my first girlfriend and all that stuff, I said, maybe I should bring some music to the people. And, you know, then I bought myself 2 decks at home, and I started mixing every day. And then, yeah, I felt that this was the new thing what gave me goosebumps again, you know, being a DJ and bringing music to the people and make them dance. Then I started buying my first records, of course. So my first things that I was playing was things like this, like David Bowie, you know. This is actually my very, very first record that I bought ever in my life. And stuff like this, I was playing, you know, first in very small bars, and I played stuff like the Sex Pistols, like Fat Gadget, you know. All this kind of stuff combined by the dance music from that period. It was 1989, 1990. Played also, there was only one DJ in that night in the clubs. From 9, 10, 11, 12 hours, this was something completely normal. Friday, every Saturday. And think, this is something very good, you know, because then you learn really to read the crowd. I was really, really glad, you know, to have my first booking outside of Belgium. It was in Spain, in Barcelona. Thanks to this record, you know, the BPM is minimum like 20 BPM more than what I make nowadays. The name is Dreamwaves. It was released on Dance Opera Records. Carl asked me the first time to make a record for his label, and this was for me my first breakthrough, honestly.
He's a good listener. He comes and checks out my parties for many, many, many years ago. And eventually, he decides that he sends some music to me. Marco was probably one of the, I think, the third release on Intet Records with a track called Play It Back. And the thing is about the sound of Marco, it was very, very strong techno, and I absolutely loved it.
After meeting Carl, you know, and developing and playing in loads of countries, I met also John Digweed, another amazing monument in the electronic music scene. Actually, I gave him first a demo, and I said, yeah, I never think that John gonna reply on this, you know. But then he replied and he said, yeah, let's do it.
Such a nice guy as well, great to hang out with. Been lucky enough with my Bedrock Records label to release several of his singles. Then we released an album from him as well, which went really well. Remixes, he's delivered some absolute corkers for the label, and a big fan of his production. So you can always find me playing a lot of Marco's tracks and remixes in my set.
This is one of my first albums, Sacrifice and Dedication, on Primate. This was one of the biggest techno labels back in the days, like 10 years ago. Yeah, this was for me also something really nice, produced also together with a good friend of me, Red Hat, because back in the days I had no studio, I had nothing, and you know, Red Hat, a very good friend of me, is something who has it really in the veins, you know, the music. He's an amazing producer.
It's always unexpected to, what's gonna happen. We start working on a track and we end somewhere where we didn't know we were gonna end, and that's always the funny part. And musically wise, we are in the same style. Maybe I'm the harder one, he's the softer one, but it works.
The move, my inspiration to move over to techno from what I was playing in the beginning and back in the days was because, you know, I really wanted to explore, and I wanted really to make a profession from it, like I have today from being a DJ. So I started playing in a bigger club in the city where I was playing in the beginning, and it was the whole night dance music. So that's why I changed also to another style of music and more came into this world, and then also started producing my first records.
I've been listening to Marco from the late 90s when he was doing techno with his label. Great tracks, great sets, and you know, I loved his music.
He's made loads of brilliant records as a producer, and he is a brilliant DJ. Brilliant at both. I mean, you just look at all his signings across all the many labels.
What I really like about Marco in the studio is he has a good background from a lot of styles, so yes, a lot of influences, and it's not always based on techno or something else, you know, it's really based on so many styles, even the old hip-hop styles. And this is what's really funny, he can come to the studio with vinyls, really old vinyls to sample, and this is what you need, these are treasures.
That's how I also came into the music what I'm playing today, because of the whole development, you know.
You're
you know, it's just a very nice guy and a very cool guy to have in the business. And I'm happy he's still going strong, you know, because you know, the years go by and some people make it and some people don't. But Marco's one of those who's like, he's like a working horse, you know, he just keeps on going, just like myself. And I respect that.
Marco Bale is what you can call a force of nature. It's like one of the most energetic persons we've ever met.
He's a great DJ. He's he interacts like with the crowd like nobody else. That's for sure.
He was running around and jumping around, making these noises, and he was jumping towards me and he was hugging me. And then he pulled off his tiger hat and I looked at him and it was Marco Bale.
Met him in sort of mid-90s when techno was obviously blowing up like it always is in Belgium, one of the best countries in Europe that's always had a stable techno scene.
In Belgium, in my small country, it was unbelievable, the scene, you know. It was like non-stop party and, you know, you could go out from Thursday till Wednesday without getting bored, and from club to club, from party to another party, to an after party, to another party, to another after party. And DJs were all together and having one community, and everybody was into that sound and into listening to tracks and going to the record stores and trying out new stuff and listening to new beats.
And we made our own style. I think that's the most important. It's the Belgium style. It evolved to something amazing.
We had an amazing time. We became really close friends and just an amazing person to be with.
But the way that how we connect as people has always been fantastic. I consider him as one of my dearest friends in the music industry.
Then came bigger events like Isle of Techno. And they started in the Vooruiting Gang, I still remember, with Daft Punk Live and Jeff Mills. With like 1,000 people or something, or 1,500. And then it grew to 35,000 people. Unbelievable, you know, with underground sounds.
I appreciate Marco a lot, not only because he is the hardest working man in techno land, and definitely and the hardest working Belgium techno guy who is known around the world for what he is doing, not only his productions but also his music and his dedication to techno.
Also Tomorrowland, look at this now, you know, also coming from Belgium and also started small, and look what it is nowadays. After me is playing Marco Carola, then Loco Dice, and then Big Boxy.
Then I am strong.
You know? I'm a big fan of Mr. Marco Bale. Playing today at Tomorrowland.
This is Ben.
He says, "Mesh, what are you doing? I'm up for it. Because his weakness is a perfect match."
But his output for his music and the way how he creates music is insane. And I just absolutely love it. Even still to this day, for sure, here at Tomorrowland, I'm going to be playing at least 3 or 4 Marco Bale records.
And this was happening in my country. I'm really, really proud of it. And that's why I think Belgium, don't forget about it. Don't forget about my country. We'll be right back.
for me, my best gig ever was playing at Carl Cox at Space, because it's, you know, it just rammed, packed. The terrace are inside and you can do whatever you want, and people from all over the world are coming and everybody goes crazy. So this is for me the biggest, the most massive goosebumps I ever had. But also playing in Tokyo, because I really love my crowd in Tokyo, because I feel so much respect coming back from Japanese people when you play in Tokyo, especially in Ageya. Really fantastic. Yeah, of course, these were for me a brilliant moments. Of course, there is my label, MB Electronics. This is my baby since now 13 years already. I started in 2000. With loads of releases, my friends Redhead and Tom Hates were producing since the beginning days. Johnny Chaos and Matthew J also releasing on Cytec, Dubfire's label. Really successful, really talented guys, and I really, really appreciate their talents. Sasha Carazzi, another guy from Italy. Also an amazing talent, Simone Tavazzi. As you see, Italy has an amazing talent in the house.
He's got one of the best techno labels in Belgium for quite a while.
It's great to work with Mark. It's always like big fun in the studio and making great tracks together.
You know, I play a lot of their records, and I heard today he was playing a lot of our records, so. You know, it's just a cool relationship.
It's just nice to know somebody like Marco, who is obviously still consistent in the scene.
Marco, keep going on for another 20 years.
But he just produces so much music. There was one time, I think, in maybe 1999, 2000, 2001, where at least 60% of my music was Marco Bailey records. It was incredible. At the time when I was doing radio shows and I had to do track lists, it was always Marco Bailey White Label, Marco Bailey White Label, Marco Bailey White Label. He would never put any bloody tracks names to any of his music because he was pumping them out so quickly. And then once I put a track out with Marco, I put another track out with Marco. I always ask him what the title was called. He could never remember. He could never tell me. So it was either Marco Bailey Side 1, 8 Track 1, It's Wicked. You know, it's like, it's incredible.
Yeah, every good record, what gives me a good feeling is for me and kind of influence. I listen a lot to rock music still at home, you know. I like drum and bass as well. I like dubstep, you know. I like house, cool, pumping house. But this is what I want to say with loving loads of styles of music. I also did this year my album High Volume on my label MB Electronics. And I have also the dark techno, what I like to play and what I'm standing for many years, the real underground. This is the Falcon from my album High Volume. I'm gonna play you now World TV. It's another track that's gonna come out soon, which when you probably see this is already out. This rocked it the whole summer for me on every dance floor that I played. Listen to World TV. I'm completely into the nightlife, and standing up, and then the first thing I do is jumping to the computer, check all the emails, and going crazy, drinking 3-4 coffees, going more crazy. No, then I go to the gym if I have the time, if it's not too busy day, you know, or go just running for like half an hour. Working on the laptop, if it is not on music, it's on emails or it's listening on tracks, and this is my whole day actually. All about the music. I started and I went to the tattoo shop and I said, well, I'm just gonna do something on my shoulder, like my logo, like the dragon or something, you know. That's enough, that's fine. If it is for me, nobody needs to see it on my shoulder. But then one more, a little bit more. And now I can't stop anymore. So yeah, pay attention. When you do a tattoo, be sure you like it, because it's an addiction. And I warn the young guys to be yourself, you know? And to not follow some hypes and to not follow, I have to be in the Beatport top 10 and I have to play Traktor because then everything is synced and everything will sound nice. Be yourself and create a personality. That's why I really respect people like Laurent Garnier, Carl Cox, of course, Sven Veit, Ricardo Villalobos. Be yourself on stage and show this also to the people, creating an own personality, you know. I wish I could always play 10, 11 hours, 12 hours, or even more, because then I could really explore myself and let myself go into the world of nice, beautiful music, which is for me fantastic. For me is being a DJ and doing what I do a dream, you know, and I hope this dream will never end. Many crazy things happen, you know, all the time, but this makes it so special, I think, in our world. That's why I'm so thankful to all my fans and all the people to still sit there and being and can do what I wanted to do and I still want to do is playing and give the best music and the best feeling to the people on the dance floor. So I think you have to give everything for the people who are there to see you. I think this is the most important. And I thank you so much for looking to my documentary. Brothers and sisters, I love you. I'm really happy and I really hope to continue still very long to rock the dance floors together with you.